wherever you go, there you are.
We've won the argument with the American people.
Hell no, to the no, 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 hell to the no.
Do you think it would be right for Mr. Trump to apologize to Muslims this morning?
Donald Trump told Today he has finally gone too far.
Is Trump doing long-term damage to the Republican brand if he's insulting Muslims, Latinos, women, veterans, prisoners of war?
Donald Trump is a narcissist and he's an egomaniac.
A jackass.
Bloviating. Ignoramus.
Well, I was appalled.
The word offensive is too weak.
Sources for today's episode, Breitbart's John Nolte and Sundance from over at the Conservative Treehouse. Both are linked up under the video at the website.
I think as long as we have black on black crime and black, you know, one black man killing another, you know, if black lives matter, then they should matter all the time.
Hey, I'm sorry, but I've seen better haircuts in a prison movie. By the way, I've decided I'm saving up my money. I want to invest in a new haircut myself. I'm going to get me a trumpador. And welcome to this Frog Leg Minute.
Charlie, do you accept Mr. Trump's explanation specifically that he wasn't talking about your face when he said face, he was talking about your persona?
No.
Lauda saw Barbara Boxer briefly on television this morning and said what everyone says, God, what is that hair?
Well, it appears the summer of Trump is now moving into the autumn of irritation. Trump won't go away.
Just can't kill the beast.
No matter what they try to do, no matter how many times they predict it, he's like Donald the Menace.
Well, this is racist crap, of course, and it's to me the big original sin of Donald Trump.
And then once we just had that ridiculous debate on CNN, which was more like a bad Jerry Springer show.
Do you feel comfortable with Donald Trump's finger on the nuclear codes?
Even the people against Trump are admitting that the establishment is just out to get Trump. I mean, Trump must be destroyed. I mean, look, 44% of the questions at that debate focused on Donald Trump. 26 questions contained Donald Trump's name. 26! And 18 of those questions were asked to the other candidates. We had a three-hour debate and nothing about our $19 trillion debt. Well, it's probably because the most qualified to deal with this type of financial problem, or more than a problem, crisis, is Donald Trump. Let him talk about it.
Who is it that's actually buying the BS here that that Donald Trump is peddling? And it's guys like this who think that the big problem is that we have Muslims in America, or the person who thinks that the Bureau of Land Management is taking people's ranches away at gunpoint.
You're an idiot.
You know what? Shame on the GOP. Shame on them for allowing the liberal, Democrat-controlled media to dictate the terms of the Republican presidential debate. And they turned it into a circus, a primetime food fight. It was ridiculous. You know, personally, I'd like to see all the candidates get together and put on their own debate. Control the format, pick their own moderators, then sell the rights to whoever wants to carry it. You know, they could make a ton of money and then split the proceeds amongst the campaigns.
She says, just like Marie Antoinette.
What this has turned into is an orchestrated effort to destroy Donald Trump. And this effort is now pedal to the metal. It's coming from the right-wing media and the left-wing media and the Republican Party and the Democrat Party. They hate the guy. Hate him. That's why we love him. Don't back down, Donald. Don't back down, brother. But I'll tell you, but look, he's going to be accused of everything. He's going to be a racist, a nativist, a protectionist, a botanist, and a ventriloquist. And those of you that regularly watch the show, you know I've spoken highly of Carly Fiorina, highly. She's a brilliant lady. And her speech the other night on Planned Parenthood was nothing short of awesome. But I ain't gonna lie, she started scaring me, man. She sounds like she's got a vicious streak. I mean, really, she seemed to have a chip on her shoulder because she's the only woman. and she seems eager to prove that she's just as tough as the guys, and she'll go to war with Russia to prove it. Well, she said, I'm not talking to Putin. I'm building up the Sixth Fleet.
I wouldn't talk to him at all. We've talked way too much to him. What I would do immediately is begin rebuilding the Sixth Fleet. I would begin rebuilding the missile defense program in Poland. I would conduct regular, aggressive military exercises in the Baltic states. I'd probably send a few thousand more troops into Germany.
Well, okay, hotshot.
I'm sorry. I'm far from a pacifist, you know. Well, to the contrary. I absolutely believe in a strong, badass military with the finest equipment available. But you know what? You exhaust every option before you send America's sons and daughters off to war. Anyway, a lot of people are calling her the anti-Hillary Clinton. I don't know. I think she's a little too hard on Hillary. What do you think?
I have such great admiration and empathy for Hillary Clinton. I have great admiration for her because I know what it takes in some small measure to do what she has done. She is obviously incredibly intelligent, focused, tough, determined, empathetic.
Breaking the law. Things are not as they seem to be.
Candygram from Angle.
You know, every week now we have a new victim of Donald Trump's outrageous insensitivity and his mean words. Did you hear what Trump said? I mean, like a bunch of schoolyard tattletales. That's our news now. Grow up.
When you tattle on someone, you're not just telling on them. You're telling on yourself.
Now, but be fair. If you read a lot of these articles, as I do, and listen to the pundits, you would have no idea that each one of these victims drew first blood. They attacked first. I'm sorry, but if you launch an unprovoked attack against somebody, you don't get to then start dictating rules. Oh, don't hit me in the face. But here's the pattern's clear, and the message is even more clear. Don't attack Donald Trump. If you do, you're going to get hit back. And you're going to get hit back hard, so you better brace yourself. But Donald Trump goes too far. He never knows when to stop. Well, then don't start. It's simple.
What do you mean you don't agree with me? Do you know who you're dealing with?
I don't even know if it's me necessarily. It's a movement. People are tired of incompetence. They're tired of these incompetent politicians. Mm-hmm. We're tired of being beaten up by China, mm-hmm. by Japan, by Mexico, by every single country that does business with us. And I think it will be an election based on competence.
I mean, does Trump say things that causes polite society to cringe? Of course he does.
Mr. Trump's language is divisive.
Somebody's always offended. Who gives a damn? Who cares? We don't care what he said about another candidate. They're not helpless puppies in a basket. We care that our nation is collapsing as a direct result of our disgraceful, greedy political class. So you'll pardon me if I don't bow to the Fox News pundit. Every aspect of our America is crumbling right before our eyes. Our military, our borders, our economy, our infrastructure, our language, our traditions. We're throwing Christians in jail, and you're worried about table manners? Jeez.
Do you want to apologize?
I will absolutely apologize sometime in the hopefully distant future if I'm ever wrong.
I sent a message to another time, but as the days unwind, this I just can't believe. I sent a note across another plane, maybe it's all a game.
Anti-Trump conservative intellectual Jonah Goldberg says, To wit, you know you have to be properly credentialed to use the phrase to wit. Anyway, and I think you have to own a couple of bow ties. He says, to wit, I don't think Trump is a conservative. I don't think he's a man of particularly good character. I don't think he can be trusted to do the things he promises. Ironically, Mr. Goldberg, that's similar to our case against the Republican establishment, except the difference is that we have a laundry list of evidence that supports our claims. So to properly articulate our position, let's change the statement around a little bit. to wit. You know what? I'll never like saying that. I'll never say that again. We know the GOP is not conservative. We know the GOP is not run by people with good character. And we know the GOP cannot be trusted to do the things that it promises. We know this. The proof's in the pudding. And the pudding tastes like crap. But see, most of us that have been loyal to the GOP for decades, I mean, me personally since Ronald Reagan, we're more offended by Boehner and McConnell than we ever were with Obama or Harry Reid. They didn't pretend to be conservative. You know, and unbelievably, just a few days ago, after giving Obama everything he wants, everything, probably even a sponge bath and a reach around, these guys, Boehner and McConnell, have the gall to claim that they're still fighting the conservative fight.
That's what we do here.
This government passed the law that they wanted to see the deal. Has anyone seen it?
Well, the side agreement between the IAEA and Iran, no one has seen, and that's another good reason to oppose the deal.
Why is that, sir?
It beats me.
Kings and queens and guillotines taking lives denied.
So this victory sends a strong message that no one, especially no president, is above being held accountable to the Constitution.
The Republican Party's inability to get anything done did not just start with these clowns. This is just the latest version of the GOP Keystone Cops. I mean, we vote on the same issues over and over and over, and we're promised the same crap over and over and over. Election Day is like that bad movie, Groundhog Day. I mean, let's go back in time to before 2007, when the Republicans controlled both houses of Congress and the White House. Did we secure the border then? No. Did we balance the budget then? No. Did we reduce the size of government by even a fraction? No. In fact, the contrary. The GOP gave us the TSA. They gave us the Patriot Act. They gave us No Child Left Behind. They expanded Medicare to include prescription drug coverage. They gave us Homeland Security. What else they give us? Gas.
Hey, don't.
The bill I'm about to sign is an important step in our nation's efforts to secure our border as I sign the Secure Fence Act of 2006.
You know, we might be slow and a little too willing to give the benefit of the doubt, but we have absolutely reached our clarion moment, and we know that nobody can be this incompetent. I mean, even a blind squirrel finds a nut every now and then, but nobody can be this incompetent without trying. And these guys, McConnell and Boehner, are intentionally throwing the fire. The Republicans inside the Beltway, they are toxic with corruption, toxic with corruption. And even in this past election, they're using Democrat tactics to help their rhino buddy Thad Cochran. They played the race card in Mississippi, and he was getting his butt beat. And the GOP comes in and pays Democrats to vote in the primary. They paid Democrats to vote in their primary. Now you tell me again why Donald Trump is so bad. What exactly has he done? Specifically, like I just gave you specifics.
Well, train, take me on out of this town. Train, let's
go. And you know what? All that benefit of the doubt that we've been giving the Republicans these years, we're ready to give it to Donald Trump now, because guess what? Trump is promising to do what the GOP's been promising for so many elections we can't even count. Secure the border, kill terrorists, simplify the tax code, give the middle class tax relief. Take care of our veterans. Fix that damn VA. And finally get a chance to take on the feckless, dishonest, cowardly, insulting, snobbish, appeasing, corrupted parasites and grifters of the Republican establishment. We've had it. And you know, as John Nolte so eloquently said, getting the big conservative things right and burning the diseased village to save the village, that sounds conservative to me. Let's go. Time to put foot to ass for God and country. Guys, so much for watching. Please stop by the website and subscribe to the show alerts and donate if you can. Frog legs are free to watch, but they're not free to make. And we can only hunt so many rhinos on a $13 budget. Please share the show with your friends, and I hope you'll come back for the next Intellectual Frog Legs. God bless.
We get it almost every night. And when that moon gets so big and bright, it's supernatural delight. Everybody was dancing in the moonlight. Everybody here is out of sight.